What's the difference between blood and power?
Is there a difference?
Yes, you're wrong.
Explain, like, what's the difference between a Damu and a Piru? Because the reason why I'm asking
you is no difference. Damu is just Swahili for blood.
Okay.
Well, so you can be blood, but not Piru.
Well, Piru is part of the blood family.
You are correct, sir.
The nigga, this, like, I hate when niggas be trying to get me mistaken for a Piru.
Yes. Well, so you can be blood, but not Piru.
Paul
Rue
is part of the blood family.
Yeah.
Well, blood
you got
Damu's too. You know what I'm saying?
So what's the difference?
A Paul Rue is something that originated from Compton. What we gonna call it, Bompton. And then from there you got
Bompton,
all your
own.
Yeah. From there you
is
got
that
all
the original blood is in.
It's a street in Compton called Paul Rue Street. And that's where it originated.
It's false. No way. Not this time. We created it.
Bang the bed, bang the set, tat on my neck, check on me, yeah, yeah, watch your step, he won't fuck, he'll just buy, ask him, so left him in dust, trust him, buy his cuss, and get drunk and talk big, smack yo, so quick and get it, hop on the strike like we used to do, fly handlebars and all stars is low, keeping it true, 7 days a week, and he's living with his mama, and I heard break, with GHGC 107.
How many blocks? What was the longest amount of blocks that you got chased before?
Blocks I got chased?
Yeah, because, hey, you got to run from niggas sometime.
Or the cops.
I ain't talking about the cops. I'm talking about the, you know, I'm talking about shit I didn't.
I ran a couple of times. The furthest I probably ran was when I was standing out front. And my homeboy, Sea Dog, rest in peace, he came over there with a nigga from Hoover. And Hoover niggas don't like O's, and I'm from 20s. This is a big old buff nigga. We standing out there. I ain't really peeping. I'm kind of like still a square. But the nigga like sizing me up, and I ain't even knowing it. And like, where you from? I'm like, 20. I'm like, I'm from 20. I'm saying it all happy and joyful and shit.
I'm from 20s.
This nigga got a bottle in his hand. Nigga hit me in the head with the bottle. Boom.
You broke.
I'm blown out.
How many blocks you ran?
About three. I was like, I know
this
that nigga.
Crazy, man. I ran about six before.
I'm like, I know this nigga can't catch me now.
He got the 20 blanks. Let me see the sir.
20
nigga, take that shit off. 20 blood. Yeah, this nigga for back is baby nuts. He don't want to fight, though. He don't want no fade. You feel me? We giving our fade. Ain't no fade. We giving our fade, man, but we just took the shirt. He ain't want the fade, so we just took the shirt. We giving our fade, though. Ain't no fade, though. Nigga, oh, Crip, come get your homie, nigga. Come get your homie, nigga.
Baby nut, you just came out your shirt, cub, and your hat, cub. Cause we don't play none of that, cub.
Nigga, the homie, cub. That nigga got 20K.
Turn around. That's what the 20 swabs got. I ain't
They call this nigga Baby Nut. He got the 20 blank. Let me see the shirt. Nigga.
HGC 106. He telling cubs how to live and he a felon. He felon. That boo's selling. You know why?
I told that nigga, I said, nigga, you look like me. Nigga, you too ugly to be a female. Nigga, what's wrong with you?
Ask me what gang affiliation done the most gangsters historical shit in Los Angeles. I'm gonna tell you the Hoovers.
Oh, hands
in. Them niggas took a blue rag, put it down, said RC don't mean Crip, it mean criminal. Our rag is orange, and nah, we ain't siding with the Bloods. We everybody killer. We CK, we Crip killing and blood killing. And survived it. Got stronger and deeper. Ain't nobody take that from them niggas. Nobody.
Crip,
I'm a problem. But what's real is real. What's real is real. Ain't nobody.
From what street to what street is y'all street?
Oh, no, we from
Y'all think about the blood? They true bloods out there.
Ain't no true bloods, but
You see the burglary rag right here, man. And you see two pins on here right here. Nigga, neighborhood, power route, 141, original block power route. Nigga, we run shit around here, nigga. We run shit, blood ain't that, nigga, say nothing to us, blood. What's all this little blood ain't that, nigga, say nothing, blood. We run with some thump, nigga, call it up, blood. We right here, blood. This right here, blood. This right here is the bricks, blood. That's who we kill niggas at right here, blood. Niggas rolling by, we pop on niggas, blood. Niggas ain't ready, blood.
R.I.P.
to
my fallen neighbors, big
back.
Rest in peace, boy.
Greatest
little dip, all my niggas,
man. Yeah, man. Ain't no other set out here ever did that.
The fuck is he talking about?
You know what I'm saying? But I survived it.
Serious shit, bro. Pyro's in the door. The Pyro's in the door. Nigga, this blood's like, what do you mean the Pyro's in the door? Nigga, this blood's like that. Nigga, this blood, like, I hate when niggas be trying to get me mistaken for a Pyro. And I hate when niggas be trying to say, like, all of a sudden now that the bloods got famous, now the Pyro's want to be bloods. No. Y'all always wanted to be a separate entity before blood. Like, serious shit, blood. I'm not gonna lie and act like blood. I remember at Juvenile Hall, the Crip niggas used to diss and be like, fuck Ops. And the Pyro niggas used to be like, shit, I ain't sure. I'm from Pyro. I'm a Pyro. Now all of a sudden, the Bloods got famous. Now, Lil Wayne didn't know which way he wanted to go. I'm a Blood. I'm a Pyro. Like, Lil Wayne got famous and put the Bloods on the map, like, really, really. And now all of a sudden, all Bloods and Pyros is the same thing. Like, yeah, we all the same. Like, blood. No. I remember when I was at Juvenile Hall at camp facility, the Crip niggas used to be like, fuck Hobbs. And the Pyro niggas used to be like, shit, I'm a Pyro. I ain't tripping, nigga. I'm a Pyro. But now that the Bloods got famous, now niggas want to be like, oh, yeah, we all Blood. We all Blood. Yeah, Blood. Like, nah, Blood, retreat, Blood. Fuck out of here, Blood. You know what I'm saying? Let's keep that same energy, blood. Serious shit, keep that same energy. Like, y'all my niggas, though. But I'm saying, blood, now that we famous now that the fame came in, keep that same energy, blood. Y'all always was my nigga. It didn't matter what. I got Pyro Tanny, blood. I'm a nigga that got Pyro Tanny, blood, so you can't never like that. You can't never say that with me. I was always accused of the rude nigga. But you niggas wasn't always a ruse to the blood niggas. Like, blood, all you niggas wasn't. The two P's was, I ain't gonna lie, the two P's was two P's in the beat. And the 30 rules, the Bloodstone Pyro. My nigga from Bloodstone Pyro said, the blood come first. You hear where I'm from? Bloodstone Pyro. I'm a Pyro, but I'm a blood. You see the blood come? Bloodstone's Pyro. Blood. Always fucked with the 30 rules. Blood. Seriously, blood. They always kept it two P's in the beat, blood. And the two P's in the beat, blood. The Pacoima Pyro, they was bull, just whack. Whack always, go on Pyro. That nigga Whack always seemed to conveniently leave out the beat. You notice that about Whack, blood? That nigga from two P's in a beat. Like, blood, there is no two P's. There is no Pacoima Pyro. There is no two P's, blood. It's two P's in a beat. Like, blood, they came out, they was two P's in a beat. Pacoima Pyro, Bloods, the blood ended that, but then all of a sudden, nigga, here come Whack. Pyro, I'm from Pacoima Pyro. What happened to the Bloods, though, blood? Weird ass nigga, like, blood, what happened to the Bloods? I'm from Pacoima Pyro. I thought it was two P's in a B, blood. Ain't no Pacoima Pyro, blood. Never heard of that, blood. It's two P's in a B. Pacoima Pyro, Bloods, blood. Whack came out. Only trying to ride the Pyro, then he thought he was gonna start something different than like starting them. No, that Pyro, on Pyro. That blood of Pyro, I ain't even fucking with you. Like, fuck you talking about, blood. Them Bonza niggas ain't feeling you right now, cuz. Like, blood, serious shit, the Bonza niggas ain't even feeling you. Like, fuck, on Pyro. What happened to the beat, though? Whack a nigga that forgot the beat. Blood got slid up under game and forgot about the beat, but all of a sudden it's two P's. Blood, no. It was always two P's and a beat. Nigga, you nigga, ain't no such thing as two P's, blood. Honestly, blood, Queen Street, ain't no such thing as two P's. Ain't no Pacoima Pyro. It's Pacoima Pyro. Bloods, nigga. Always been two P's in a beat, but ever since Whack came out, all of a sudden it's only two P's. What happened to the beat? What happened to the beat? bust her ass, brother. Fuck you, brother. I don't give a fuck about none of that Queen Street, brother. Oh, no. What happened to the beat? Two peas in it. It's Pacoima Pyru, but all of a sudden here come what? Pacoima Pyru. What happened to the B, you bitch ass nigga, like that serious shit, man? And don't call no crib. Don't call my crib, homie, to come talk. Like, I know you gonna see this. But don't call no crib to call me. Hey, wait, hold on, this nigga. Hey, crib, my crib partner, Bosco talking shit. Call Bosco.
Now, it don't take much to find this. Yeah, the Hoover Crips are... That, like, this is what they're described as. Listen, the 5-1 Trouble Hoover Crips. The 5-1 Street Gang is a conservative movement. You hear that? Conservative. Oh, wow. Says here, and are backed and supported by Washington, D.C. because of their ancestry in the American Indian Wars. Wow. So, let me read that one more time. They are backed, which means funded, they're backed and supported by Washington, D.C. So this is why I'm saying, any Joe Blow on the street, any profane-staying idiot, if you ask him and put him on the fucking show and interview, you know what they're going to say? The 5-1 Troubles are a goddamn black gang. How are they a black gang if... They're backed and supported by Washington, D.C. because their ancestry in American Indians, or in American Indian Wars. So they're getting called American Indians, but in y'all interviews, y'all calling them black. And then when we hear about these RICO cases, they're labeling them a black gang and calling them criminal entities when these dudes are... being backed and supported by the Washington, D.C., being backed by the government. California is really Pyru, like, for real. It's a Pyru town, Pyru street that's only in California. Then you have Pyru Lake, you have Pyru town, you know, you have this Indian connection too, right? They call them the Pirus, the Piru Native Americans, right? If y'all look that up, y'all can find it. Are the Pirus getting some of that recognition from the United States government for, you know, tribal acceptance and initiation through that, for, you know, some sort of relief from the experiences and traumatization that they had being labeled or mislabeled black, Negro, and colored, right? And like, those are the conversations, those are the questions that need to be answered. I would love for all the Pyru homies that follow me, if y'all would get in my comment section, let us know, let the homies know, let other Pyrus know where to go to get, you know, on board to that so that they can get relief from the trauma that they've gone through economically, socially, mentally, physically, and spiritually, so that they become free and that they can do what's best for their neighborhoods and their own bloods. But yeah, I feel like California belongs to Pyrus. Now, before y'all jump all in the comments going on nuts, Pyru Street ain't the only street, right? You got Hoover Street, right? I think Hoover Street should be, considered. I do think they should be considered, some sort of entity that is, you know, a victim of, you know, the fucking lies of the United States government. I think they're victims of the United States government in one way or the other. You know, I would love to see some sort of, treaty or peace treaty or whatever between a lot of the neighborhoods, you know what I'm saying, grants and funding being released to those neighborhoods. Because if y'all don't know, you know, the United States government takes in hundreds of millions of dollars, trillions of dollars, and those dudes are just lining their pockets with it, man. The fucking United States governors and shit like that, they're just lining their pockets with it, bro.
So, yeah, I'm not tripping on Power Street getting a check or Hoover Street getting a check. We just got to keep it real, though. Hoover's predate the crab identity. You know what I'm saying? The Hoover Street actually ties back to something beyond them, right, that they wanted to identify with. By the end of the day, I feel like we just bloods. We blood tribes. And, you know, why couldn't the Hoovers identify as Pyrus, right, if they wanted to partake or at least get a piece of the Pyru, identity or alliance or whatever, right, as far as to get on board as bloods, at least, you know, as sharing a common race and a common lineage. You know, that's what bloods are. Anybody's family, anybody's blood relatives, you're related by blood through common ancestry. And the Hoover share common ancestry with Pyrus. And they both have a very similar nature, very similar style. You know, they're throwing up the same signs. You know, they move and behave very similarly. You know, and the rest of the Crips do. But I'm just saying, like the Crips, you know, the formation and the organization and stuff like that, I feel like has to be renamed, you know. It has to evolve, you know. Just like all the old gangs that no longer served a purpose, they fell out of favor and they changed and evolved. You know, why wouldn't the Crips have that going on right now, especially when their identity is falling out of favor? You know, the crowd identity has died with Raymond, with Tookie, with, you know, the rest of them, you know.
Like, clearly, I feel like Hoover should be a part of the, you know, reconstruction of California. You know, they are a street that's been there for dating back some time. The only street that doesn't exist, the only history that doesn't exist as fake false history is the Crip Street, you know. There is no Crip Street. There is no Crip Park. Crip ain't shit but a Pyru reject. That's all a Crip is, bro. Crip in reverse is Pyru. That's all it is. It's a reject Pyru. That's all what you gotta say. When you're referencing Crips, all you're doing is referencing reject. But obviously I could go on and on and on, but shout out to all the Pyrus out there. You know, I feel like personally, since the Hoovers got a whole state, like the Hoovers, like their state could be like Texas, right? Like the Hoovers got a whole fucking state. Like, come on now, what state's more Hoover Street than Texas, nigga? I'm telling you, the Hoovers, you know, the Hoover identity in California should be a blood identity. Like, it should remain blood. It started off as bloods and should always remain and be bloods. But I feel like the Hoover bloods should be, you know, the face of Texas. Like, you know, come on now. Like, what is more Hoover than the entire state of Texas? You know what I'm saying? It's a Hoover state, like, by far.
I attracted you to make this, to do this film.
Well, I read the script, and the film, a lot of the script is cut out of the film, actually. But when I read the script, the character, I said, you know what, this is a character who I think kids can learn something from, or gangbangers can learn something from. He's a guy who's, as we say in the States, an ex-OG. OG means original gangster. And he is really trying to reform his life. And he's trying to set an example for Tyrese's character named Jody about these are some of the pitfalls that can happen to you, and he really doesn't want the kid to make the mistakes that he's made in life.
The fuck is he talking about?
Well, in a nutshell, I'll just kind of focus on my character. The film is really about the rites of passage from boyhood to manhood. What is it to be a black man? What is it to be a man? Unfortunately, many times in the States, when you grow up in a poverty-stricken environment, being a man may be having children out of wedlock. How many kids can you have? That's macho. Being a man may be, I've been in jail for 5 years. That's macho. Or I shot somebody. That's macho. Or being tough. And I think in reality, the film deals with those issues. It also deals with issues of matriarchal households. We call it babies having babies. Young girls having babies, you know, for love. many times. Well, I grew up in Harlem, so, I mean, there's not too much difference between ghetto to ghetto in the United States or poverty to poverty in the United States. And I worked with a guy named Big Cat. He's a former gang member. He was with the Crips. And so I based a lot of this on his life. I spent a lot of time with him. And hopefully the youth, he's now working with the youth trying to, you know, get them out of the gang life. And hopefully they can see that basically the future of life in a gang is death. I worked with him on Rosewood, which honestly I think is a better directed film. I think this film, the script that he wrote, was much more poignant and had much more depth than the actual film. So I think that the film sometimes took more commercial route.
Yeah, all right. Ooh. Yeah, bitch, that's our shit too. Stop motherfucker playing, talking about who motherfucker took what, bitch. So all you do is steal motherfucking crabs. Oh, a bunch of criminals.
What?
Gangsters, pranksters, studio flunkies, junkies, monkeys.
Stupid ass.
Backbiters, bad pinchers. Oh yeah, get off me, bitch. Get off. I'm stepping on crabs.
What?
Move me.
Alright.
Let's go. Yeah. I don't give a fuck if you like ego or respect the dog.